So before going to the Twitter design, we have to know certain key things. They are fanout, social graph, Redis cache, load balancers, MySQL database, and SolarForm. What is fanout? So in computer industry, you can say like if you want a pass information from one machine to multiple machines, that is called as a fanout. So it's basically you have data in one machine, you spread across multiple machines in parallel, right, without any interruption, right? So that is called fanout. What is social graph? Social graph is a data structure which is predominantly used in all the social medias like LinkedIn or Facebook or Google search, whatnot, right? So what it does is it creates a relation between different nodes. For example, if you log into the system, you see you have multiple friends and you can say certain items like, you know, certain articles you might be liking, right? So you can have this information stored in multiple nodes and you can have a relation. So you can query the social graph to understand, like, you know, if you want to understand who, what are the articles you like into the like, right? Or what are the articles you have liked it, right? So you can get all this information with the help of social graph data structure, right? And what is Redis cache? Redis cache is, it's a key value pair where you store information in key and you have multiple data or multiple value points in the as a value. Now you give a key and query that, you get list of values. For example, in this case, if I want to get into the home screen and if I want to see the home time series, right? So you log into the system, your system queries for your user ID, what are the messages you have tweeted, right? So you can get those informations or you can store those kind of informations in the Redis cache, right? So what is load balancer? So we talked about load balancer in one of the earlier video. I would suggest you or recommend you to go into that and have a look to have a more information on that. I think most of the guys are familiar with MySQL database. It's nothing but a relational database to store the informations, right? SolarForm. So basically SolarForm is used in Twitter or any applications to have a search or to create an index out of search, and you can get you can query the index and get the search information, right? So these are the some of the softwares and key terminologies used in designing of the Twitter. Okay, this slide talks about what you should not answer in an interview, right? So if I ask a question like how to design a Twitter, most of the candidates say like, you know, they have a database where all the information is like tweet ID, tweet messages, everything is stored in the database. And when we want certain information, we can query the database by giving a select statement, right? So this is not going to work if you want to build a scalable system. So keep in mind that when you're asked a question like, you know, how do you design a robust system, you have to think beyond the databases, you have to think beyond what you have been doing in the high school graduate or in the undergraduate thing, right? Now let's jump into the certain use cases within the Twitter system design. See, in this we are going to talk primarily about four different use cases. One is home screen time series, second is user screen time series, then talk about search, and we'll talk about follow, right? And if you need more use cases, please comment or don't forget to subscribe to see the future informations, right? Okay, what you see on the screen is an architectural diagram, or you can call it a system design diagram for Twitter, right? So if you look at the system, you know, here we have the computers or, you know, the phones which are accessing the load balancers through the CDN, and you have multiple services like, you know, create tweet, view tweet, view users tweet, and search the tweet, follow users, and you can add more services when based on your scalability or the new requirements, then you have a create account, right? So we can have all the services built in, all the services set up in Docker, and you can deploy in multiple pods, right? And you can configure like a auto scaling, or you can pre-scale and keep it based on your necessity and need, right? So with respect to the data, I have talked about the primary databases, which is user table, which has the information about the user and its details, account, etc. We use this table when the user creates an account. Let's say user creates an account, we store that information in the user table. And the second service I want to talk about is follow users, right? So follow user is very simple. Let's say all the information which is stored in the social graph. As we talked about social graph, a social graph is nothing but it creates a relation between you and your objects or your entities which you are related to, right? For example, you are following certain information or you're following a certain article, that relation is maintained over here, and that's what we have in the social graph data structure. Like, right, let's say if I use the service and if I query and asking a question like, you know, hey, give me the list of users, who am I following, then you go into the social graph and query that and get those information and display in the UI, right? And the other one is search tweet, right? So whenever we create a tweet, the tweet informations are stored in the tweet table. Now there is a relation between the tweet table and the Solr form. The tweet table has all the text which you have tweeted or which your followers has tweeted, and the social and there is a Solr form which runs in the backend. It gets all the tweet messages, related ID, and it starts to index all those information and keeps in the Solr form, right? Now when we go and use a service like search tweet, it goes and queries in the Solr form and gets the all information and shows up in the UI. In between there is a search filter, right? So let's say if you want to remove certain violation words, or if you want to remove certain information from the search or from the search results, you can use the search filter and you can apply the filter on the text and you can remove all those information and show up in the UI. That's where we have a search filter, right? And this service is view user tweet, right? So let's say if somebody has tweeted or you have logged into the system and you have tweeted, all your information is stored in the tweet table, right? So now if I want to query that information, I can give you a Twitter ID, and based on that I can get all your tweet IDs, right? And those informations, all the tweet informations can be gathered from here, and we can bring as a JSON object and show up in the UI, that is user tweet, right? I want to discuss in detail about these two services, which is create tweet and view home, right? So what is view home? This service is basically a time series which is on the home screen. As soon as you log into the screen, you see the tweets which has been tweeted by your followers, right? So how do we do this, right? So if you look clearly here, what happens is when user creates a tweet, the message goes over here and it is fanned out, right? How it is fanned out? So it goes into the Redis form and it figures out who are your fans, and based on that it sends all your tweet messages and puts as a value for each tweet ID, right? So how is it done? So three different activities are happening here. So as soon as you create a tweet, it goes into a social graph and it figures out who are your followers, right? Let's say you are a user A and you have followers like B, C and D, right? Now you have B, C and D as a key in the Redis form. In the B, C and D, it goes and puts the tweet message which you have sent, right? So if you see in this data structure of the Redis form, you will see something like B, and what are the tweet messages it has to be shown for the B when he is logging in, right? If C is logging in, it will show up what are the tweet messages which has to be shown for C when he is logging in. That's where this service comes into picture. When you go into view home, it has a lookup service. What lookup service does is it goes and figures out for this user which Redis form or which Redis cache is having your tweet information. Let's say it figured out the Redis one is having the your tweet information. In that, it goes and queries and say, hey, I am user B who has logged into the system. Let's figure out what are the Twitter information for B. So it creates a JSON structure and it takes it to the UI, and where we can display it in the UI screen. So that's what create tweet and view home services are used, right? And if you have any questions, please make sure you comment so that you know I can answer in your comment sections, and also I can add more use cases into that if you are really interested. Let's talk about operational challenges, right? The first thing is top followers, right? So we would have noticed, like, you know, the celebrities and presidents have hundreds and hundreds of millions of followers, right? So now if they have these many followers, and if they tweet and those messages has to go across 100 million followers, right? So it is not possible in the real time. For example, if they have a tweet and it is very difficult to fan out fan out to go and see 100 million followers and add their tweets into each of the values in the Redis cache, right? It's very difficult. It is going to take a lot of time. So it leads to an inconsistency, right? It's going to take a lot of time. Means when some user comes into the UI, they may not be seeing the what the tweet message is for that particular user, right? So how do we navigate this scenario? So what Twitter actually is doing is when somebody wants to view the home screen, right? They come into the Redis cache, they get all the tweet messages of their followers, and during the runtime, what they do is they go and get the tweet messages of the celebrities, or they go and tweet messages of the user who has high number of followers, and they embed or they merge that and they show up in the UI, right? So in that way, they can reduce the latency time and also make sure that the data is coming to the UI seamlessly. The second thing I want to talk about is Redis cache, how to rebuild that, right? So let's say you have different Redis caches. Let's say one of the Redis is down or it got crashed. So all the information which is stored in the Redis gets crashed, or you lose that information. Now we have to rebuild that information. So rebuilding is nothing but you do the same process, I mean repeatedly, go for that specific user, right? Figure out who are the followers for them, and go and you get all the tweet information from the tweet table and reconstruct the Redis cache or a Redis cache and add it to the Redis form. So that is called rebuilding of the Redis cache, right? The third operational issue which we see is search filters. See, nowadays if you see a lot of legal things has been added, like you show certain countries have certain informations, like you should not show up certain messages, right? So they would say some of the messages should not be shown in the certain countries. So what should you do in this case? It's a dynamic thing. It keep changes based on the current laws existing in the country, right? So in order to make sure that you get a right thing onto the UI, we have to keep on updating the search filter. Let's say if you don't have the search filter, whatever you have in the Solr form, and if you query that based on your search, it is going to come up to the UI and show up, right? So if you have a search filter and if you keep maintaining that in such a way that having certain information which has to be removed and it has to be displayed at the UI, we can use the search filter, right? So if search filter is not appropriate, it shows up into the UI which is not required, and it leads to legal issues, right? So that is why we need to have a search filter. Yeah, that's it I have about the Twitter system design. If you have any questions, you can comment and make sure to subscribe and like and share so that you can get the future informations or future videos very quickly. Thank you.